Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Salam sejahtera. Today I will be presenting about the National Philosophy of Education NPE or FPK, Falsafah Pendidikan Kebangsaan in Malay. So we start off with what is National Philosophy of Education? It is an education policy that has been implemented in Malaysia. Based on the NPE, every educational is held to achieve the main essence of NPE, which is to produce balanced human being in many terms such as physical, emotional, spiritual, intellectual, and social. Next is the formulation of NPE. The Education Act 1996 said that the NPE was replaced in 1996. I tried to translate from the book, but the result was the same, so it's actually Falsafah Pendidikan Negara, FPN, 1998, replaced by Falsafah Pendidikan Kebangsaan, FPK, also known as the present NPE. And the NPE 1996 states that in Malaysia, education is a continuous effort. It's to produce balanced and harmonious human beings on a lot of aspects based on faith and obedience to God. It's also to produce Malaysians who are knowledgeable and can contribute to the harmony of their family, their community, and their country. The formulation of the NPE is based on 9 factors. Razak's statement, which is a Malayan educational proposal written in 1956, Rahman Talib report that served the basis of the educational framework for independent Malaya. Education Act 1996, a Malaysian law which enacted to provide for education. Cabinet Committee Report 1974 and 1979, a review of education policies. Rukun Negara, Principles of Education, Educational Goals, and National Education Policy, which the purpose is to broaden access to unify a diverse population through a common curriculum and language. Moving on, the description of NPE. The NPE is described through 15 elements. The first one is education is a continuous effort. We as humans need to adapt ourselves to various changes that happens in our lives. So a planned education of various stages of life takes place. To adapt to rapid change, a person needs to equip themselves with the latest knowledge and skills. Education is the process of acquiring knowledge and skills as well as the absorption of noble values to become knowledgeable, energetic, virtuous human beings. This educational process is an ongoing process of a lifetime. So this continues the education is starting from the basic education in the early stages of children at home and kindergarten, continued in primary and secondary schools in the stages of children and adolescents. Next is B, developing individual's potential. An individual is born with various abilities, and these abilities and talents can be developed through interaction with the environment and quality education. Because education plays a key role in developing the potential of the individual. Each individual has their own potential. However, not everyone knows their potential. Therefore, individuals who have identified their potential and abilities will exist through social interactions with people around the environment. Through education, the community will have the opportunity to expand and increase their potentials. In schools, there are many co-curricular activities and that has been erected to provide a balance in academics and outdoor activities. Student involvement in co-curricular activities can be observed in sports activities, clubs, associations, and uniforms. From this activity as well, a student will be able to develop themselves in various fields. C. Developing potential in a holistic and cohesive way. We humans always strive to meet the needs to enable humans to do this. All potentials need to be developed. So many agree that the talents, potentials, and abilities that exist in a person very closely referred to each other. The potentials of an individual must be developed in an integrated manner and cannot be separated from each other. For example, potential from an intellectual point of view cannot be separated from spiritual potential. This is because a wise student will not be balanced without the existence of humanitarian norms such as spiritual and physical potential in one activity cannot be separated from social skills such as love and respect for others. D. A balanced and harmonious person. A balanced and harmonious person means a person who possesses and appreciates knowledge. They have noble morals, strong faith, and confidence in God. A balanced human being means that all humans need, namely mental growth, spiritual, emotional, and physical development in a healthy and integrated manner are at a good level. Harmony, on the other hand, means that the spiritual, intellectual, emotional, and physical elements in human beings are in compatible and appropriate state. This situation will bring about good relations between man with man with the environment, and also with God. The national philosophy of education plays a role in producing a balanced and harmonious society, such as having knowledge, good personality, believing in God, and having good morals and good personal health. E. Intellectual element. This element focuses on thinking that includes characteristics such as having 3M, basic skills, acquiring, improving, and disseminating knowledge and utilizing knowledge for oneself and others. F. Spiritual element. This element is related spiritually, such as realizing the existence of the Creator, appreciate and being grateful for the greatest gift, and realizing the responsibility to form more morals. G. Emotional element. Strong feelings of the soul includes characteristics such as feelings of calm and control, behavior, as well as appreciating and valuing beauty and art. H. Physical element. Focuses on the development of a healthy body, maintaining a healthy body, doing leisure, developing breeds and manipulative skills for the benefit of society, and striving to increase productivity. Belief. Next is I. Belief and obedience to God. Acknowledging the existence of the Creator, man and nature were created by the Creator, doing good and avoiding evil, following and practicing religious teachings, and realizing that men are fully responsible for his actions and strengthen religious beliefs. Belief in God is the seventh element in the formation of the national philosophy of education. They should be grateful for all his favors and gifts. This gives them an awareness of the laws and phenomena of the universe, that its rules that have been set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only that, they will also be aware that each individual is responsible for all actions taken, whether good or bad. J. Knowledgeable Malaysians' love of knowledge. Fond of reading, utilizing knowledge for the benefit of self and others, constantly adding knowledge, improvising, and disseminating knowledge, and broad and open-minded. Shaping knowledgeable Malaysians is an element that is highly emphasized in the national philosophy of education. This element provides advice to the people to cultivate a love of reading, love of science, and use it to benefit themselves and others. Knowledgeable Malaysians are also people who have characteristics such as open-mindedness. If this element is properly practiced in school, students will be more aware of their purpose to school and the importance of knowledge itself. K. Skilled Malaysians. They have the knowledge and qualifications appropriate to the task, and they have the skills to carry out the task and perform it efficiently and perfectly. People with knowledge and skills are always willing to contribute to the progress of the country. They are not only to perform the task in a short period of time, but also efficiently and perfectly. Skilled Malaysians are citizens who have the following characteristics. A. Knowledgeable and qualified in accordance with the task entrusted. B. Have appropriate skills in the performance of tasks. C. Able to perform tasks efficiently and perfectly. L. A virtuous Malaysian. A person who knows good and bad values. They are aware of the effects of good and bad deeds. They practice good behavior and they feel confident in good values. People with polite behavior, honest courtesy, trust integrity, and practice it in daily life. This element is the main thing that is emphasized so that Malaysian is able to think, act, and evaluate the good and bad things. M. Responsible Malaysians. These citizens are aware of duties and responsibilities is a trust and must be performed properly. Constantly improve productivity to develop themselves, family, society, religion, race, and country. An individual will certainly be more trusted and respected if this element is practiced. The element of responsibility in question does not mean being responsible for job duties only, but it covers various aspects of responsibility such as responsibility that I just said before. N. Malaysians who are able to achieve personal well-being. They have a sane mind, a calm soul, and a healthy body, have a strong resilience to face the challenges of life, and establish good relationships. O. Malaysians who can contribute to the harmony and prosperity of the family, society, and the country. People who are patriotic and love the country. They appreciate the principles of Rukun Negara, maintain and defend the constitution, advancing the economy towards the development of the nation and country by using science and technology. To summarize this topic, philosophy is a study of the human mind in nature, and education and society are interconnected with each other. The educators have designed the National Philosophy of Education, NPE, which is the foundation system in Malaysia. It is important for readers to understand philosophy wholly. There is a question for you to answer. What if the formulation of the National Philosophy of Education is not based on the 9 factors mentioned earlier? State your reasons. I think that's all for me. Thank you very much.